Hi everyone, and welcome to our second BritCent podcast with me, Sam, a teacher here at BritCent.
And me, Tom, also a teacher at BritCent.
Today we're going to be talking about London, and more specifically about people's opinions on London, this huge city that we're in.
Massive.
Just to start, I will get the ball rolling. Tom, how long have you lived in London?
I've lived in London for 22 years, not in a row, but as a total. So quite a significant proportion of my life. How about you, Sam? How long have you lived in London?
So I've lived here almost 5 years. So I'm from Cambridge originally. It's my hometown or home city, really.
Very nice.
But you're a Londoner, aren't
you? That's true. I think that is justified, yeah.
So which part of London are you from? North, south, east, west?
I'm from northwest London, which is mainly considered one of the wealthier areas of London, generally. Though now every area of London really has a wealthy part. And where are you living at the moment?
Well, I'm also in North London as
well.
I'm in a place, Muswell Hill, which is in the northern part of, or sort of northeast part of London. And yeah, it's quite a wealthy area. But like you said, all parts of London have wealthy parts, have poorer parts. It's a real mix. What do you think are people's first impressions generally when they move to London from another part of England or the UK?
So I think London is probably the fastest place in the UK, meaning things seem to happen very quickly. People seem to walk around very quickly. Buses leave quickly. Trains go quickly. Everyone's very seems very busy. Whereas, although there are, of course, many other big cities in other parts of the UK, I don't think any of them are quite as congested and quite as fast as London. So I think that would be the main first impression. Would that match your first impression? What was your first impression of London?
Very similar to that. Yeah, it's a very hectic city, very busy place. So that's one side of London I don't really like very much, because after a while, I realized that I had started to become quite impatient when I was traveling. And I think a lot of people just want to get to work very quickly, which is understandable, but it can be difficult if you're not from London and you have all these people trying to get different places.
True that.
And yeah,
real talk.
They just can't get there in time, it seems. It's a really interesting city as well. I mean, there's so much to do, so much to see.
Amazing.
You can never really get tired of London. Well, maybe you can, but I've never really got tired of London. There's so much to see. I think even people who have lived in London all their life have not seen everything.
That's absolutely true.
So how many of the tourist sites have you seen?
Oh, I'm probably not actually the best tourist. I mean, it's a common paradox, which is that Londoners don't necessarily know all the tourist attractions or don't necessarily see all the tourist attractions. So things like London Bridge, Houses of Parliament, things like Madame Tussauds, I've not been to. I'm sure I've been to the Tower of London when I was younger. I've been on the London Eye when I was younger, overpriced, but pretty good if you don't know the London skyline. Probably better for tourists than for locals. I'm trying to think of what else people do. You know, walking around places like Trafalgar Square, I've done that. Going to the theatre, the big musicals, I've done that. British Museum, of course. National Galleries, absolutely. Love a bit of art. How about you?
Well, I came to London quite a few times when I was younger. And I think anyone who lives near London goes to London with their school for school trips, to see the museums and to see the famous parts of London. So I definitely did that. I also remember when I came to live here, I didn't actually realize the difference between, for example, Tower Bridge and London Bridge.
There are a lot of bridges.
Lots of bridges, yeah. So I thought Tower Bridge and London Bridge were the same thing, but actually the famous bridge that people see in pictures is called Tower Bridge, whereas London Bridge, it's actually a very boring bridge.
It's rubbish.
It's the worst bridge in the city by far. But I haven't been on the London Eye.
Don't need to.
Exactly. That's because everyone's told me it's terrible. So I've had no desire.
But tourists and people visiting London, please do go on the London Eye. It will help our economy, which is what tourism is about.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So obviously, like we were saying before, people have different views on London. Some people in the UK actually don't like London, but many people absolutely love it and love living here. I really enjoy living here. So, Tom, what's your favourite thing about London?
I think my favourite thing about London is the culture, the range of cultural events that are available. I try to do something cultural every week, because otherwise I feel like I'm not making the most out of London. So the number of theatres is amazing. The cinemas are amazing. The galleries are amazing. The concerts are amazing. I'm not much of a food person, but if you try, I think you can find many incredible food places. So all of that mixes together to create a very diverse, mixed, varied, high quality culture, I think. And for me, that's extremely valuable. How about you, Sam? What's your favorite thing about London?
Oh, well, I was going to try and be different, but mine's probably quite similar.
That's all right.
However, I am a bit more interested in food. I might even call myself a foodie.
Oh, there you go.
I love trying all the different food that we have in London, all the different types of food. Obviously, we have food from every corner of the world here. It's a really cosmopolitan aspect of London. And so I think, just trying all the food in places like Chinatown, where you can get very good, quite authentic Chinese food. I remember I tried pie and mash. It's a very traditional British, or I should say London, meal or dish with mashed potato and a pie. I think it's usually a meat pie.
Yeah.
And it has sauce on.
It's good. Gravy?
Gravy. Yeah, gravy too. I haven't tried jellied eels.
Oh, no way.
Which
no
are thanks. Another traditional East London dish.
Yeah.
Which is eels in jelly, as the name suggests.
Gross.
But it doesn't sound nice.
No.
So yeah, the food for me is definitely an amazing thing. But I'd also agree that really the culture, I think, is the best thing about London. We've got some great pubs as well. For example, very close to here at Britsend, there's a pub that is over 400 years old.
Yeah, still standing.
I think, built in the 1660s. Small things like that, that's all part of London's culture, I find really interesting.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Now, I suppose the opposite side of this is, what is your least favorite thing about London? What don't you like?
That's a good question as well. I think my least favorite thing about London is the cost. It's the most expensive place in the UK, I think. I'm pretty sure of that. It's only getting more expensive as time goes by. I think one of the main problems is relating to housing. I think this is a common problem. I know this is a common problem in South Korea, especially Seoul. House prices rising, making it extremely difficult for people to own a house or to even rent a house. So there are very high numbers of young people in particular living with their parents into their mid-30s and older. So the price of things is very, very high. And sometimes it seems justified when you're having, you know, an amazing cultural experience, you're seeing a great play, production, you think, okay, this, I'm happy to spend this much money. But when you're buying a pint for £6.50 a Saturday night, you feel a little frustrated, perhaps like something is slightly wrong. How about you, Sam? What's your least favorite thing about London?
Well, I think the price of a pint of beer is one of the most one of the things I dislike the most. We often measure how much things are or how expensive places are, I think, by talking about how much a pint of beer is.
That's true. That's true.
So I went to university in a city called York in the north of England, and there was one place there where you could buy a pint of beer for, I think it was £2.
Bloody hell! Really?
Whereas here, like you said, £6 sometimes. So that's, I definitely agree about the price. I think also for me, it's the hectic lifestyle that we talked about before. That was very difficult for me to get used to because Cambridge is a little bit more relaxed as a city, and everyone cycles in Cambridge. It's a bit more difficult to cycle in London. And also after some time living here, I discovered that I had become like a Londoner. I started to become quite impatient. I got annoyed if I had to wait for a train for 5 minutes, when actually in Cambridge, sometimes you have to wait an hour for a bus. I've started to become more impatient like that. So that's the side of London I don't really like. You know, it's still a great city. It's a bit too hectic.
No, I agree.
We'd love it if you can give us your opinions on London, if you've been to London, and if you can post those in the comment section under this podcast. And also, if you have not been to London, then if you can give us your impression of London, what you think London is like, even if you have not been here, and then we can talk about it in the next podcast.
Okay, now it's time for our word of the podcast. But first, we want to give a shout out to Fox Bear for their lovely comment on our first podcast. Fox Bear said that their New Year's resolution is to start YouTube channel and to improve my English from the intermediate level to the advanced level. That is a brilliant resolution.
Definitely.
I hope all my students who are at the intermediate level have the same resolution. Thank you very much for that comment, Fox Bear. And thank you to everyone who commented on the first podcast, all one of you. And the word of today's podcast is the verb assimilate. Assimilate means when you adjust to a new situation. So we often use it when we talk about people moving to a new place or going on holiday somewhere, is how did you assimilate to the culture? How did you get used to the culture? Did you find it easy to learn the language, learn the customs, learn the manners, keep up with the pace of the place, etc.? So Sam, if you assimilate to London, does that mean you feel like you belong in London or you feel like you don't belong in London?
I think it feels like you belong in London. Yeah,
absolutely. Top marks for Sam.
Thank you very much.
He is now reaching the upper intermediate level of English.
Finally. So let's talk about some of the vocabulary from the podcast today. We've used a lot of phrases and words. And one that we used near the start was to get the ball rolling. And this is expression we use. To get the ball rolling means to start thinking or planning for something. For example, if you are in a meeting where you are discussing a project that you need to do for work, someone might say, okay, let's get the ball rolling. Mm-hmm. That means let's start planning, let's start thinking about what to do. Tom, if you get the ball rolling, does it mean that you don't spend much time planning or thinking about something? Or does it mean that you start to plan or think about doing something?
It means that you start to plan and think about doing something.
Exactly. So very useful, quite informal expression, but it's not too informal. So you can use it at work sometimes.
Very common at work, I think.
Yeah.
Sure.
So yeah, very, very useful expression there.
The next word we picked out is the word congested. The word congested means when there are lots of people in a very small area. So anywhere that's very busy, where there's lots of traffic, for example, or where there are lots of people squeezed into a single tube carriage, that is congested. And I'm sure that many of you who commute in Seoul will know the meaning of this word congested. So Sam, if I get on a congested bus, does that mean there are lots of people on the bus, or does it mean that there is no one on the bus?
Oh, I think it definitely means there are lots of people.
Absolutely. That is correct.
So a word that's sort of connected to that and connected to how busy London is the word hectic. And this is an adjective we use to describe somewhere or to describe a situation that is very busy and where people are rushing or the situation is being rushed. So Tom, if I say, oh, I had a difficult day at work today, everything was very hectic, I had a hectic time, does that mean that I've had quite a slow and relaxed day at work? Or does it mean I've had quite a fast, busy day at work?
It means you've had quite a fast, busy day at work.
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm. The next expression you might have heard us use was make the most of. And this can be make the most of it or make the most of something. To make the most of something is when you have a situation and you try to get all the best things out of the situation. So for example, let's say you go on holiday and you want to make the most of it. That means you will fill your time doing as many of the best things you can possibly do. Also, if you're in a bad situation, you can use this phrase. For example, if you're in a job that you don't like, people might say, just try to make the most of it. What this means is even though you're in a bad situation, you can still try to get the best things out of that situation. So Sam, if you visit London and you make the most of it, does that mean you stay in your hotel room for the entire week, looking at your phone, does it mean that you go out, you see the sights, you take in the culture, you go around, you do lots of things?
So it definitely means that you go out and see the sights and take everything in.
Absolutely.
So the last word that we talked about was foodie. Now, this is a noun that's used to describe a person who is very passionate and cares a lot about food. Often they think of themselves as like an expert on food. They might not actually be an expert, but they definitely think that they know a lot about food and that they appreciate food. For example, if I love going to restaurants and trying the food in different restaurants, I'm a foodie. If I don't care about the food and I just go to eat and to stop feeling hungry, I'm not a foodie. So Tom, you said before that you are not a foodie. So can you explain why you're not a foodie?
So I'm not a foodie because I'm not particularly interested in food. I don't seek out restaurants. I don't know the best places to go and eat. Food is just a functional thing for me. So that's why I'm not really much of a foodie.
Whereas I would say I am a foodie, I think, because I love trying different types of food in different restaurants. And it's something I'm quite enthusiastic about. But I know I'm not a real expert. However, I think of myself.
You try your best.
I try my best, yeah. So if there's any vocabulary in the podcast that we did not mention, but that you are confused about or that you don't really understand or you want to know more about, please write a comment in the comment section under the podcast and we will try to reply to you and explain what it means. So thank you very much for listening.
Thank you.
I hope if you haven't been to London that you come and experience London, put some money into our economy. But until next time, it's goodbye from me, Sam.
And goodbye from me, Tom.
And we'll see you soon.
See you soon. Take care.
Wait.
Bye.